हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द मैथमेटिक्स क्लास। टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग एक्सरसाइज 4.3 रिमेनिंग क्वेश्चंस, दैट इज फ्रॉम क्वेश्चन नंबर 4। सो बिफोर गोइंग विद द क्लास, लेट मी रीड द क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 4। व्हाट इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 4, एक्सरसाइज 4.3? The sum of the reciprocal of Rahman's age 3 years ago and 5 years from now is 1/3. Find his present age. So student, they are talking about Rahman's age. So let us consider the age of Rahman be X. Let the present age of Rahman be X years. Okay student, now what they are talking? They are talking Rahman's age 3 years ago. So we know 3 years ago, what does ago means? Past. So when we go to the past, what happens? Our ages gets reduced, means we go for subtraction process. So 3 years ago, what will be Rahman's age? Rahman's age equal to X minus 3 years. Okay student, what is our next condition? 5 years from now. So 5 years from now, 5 years from now का मतलब क्या हुआ? अभी से 5 साल बाद। So we are going to the future. So when I go to the future, what will happen? My age will be added. Next year मेरा एज क्या होगा? अभी जितना है उससे 1 साल बढ़ जाएगा। So when we go for the future, our ages get added up. So 5 years ago, Rahman's age will be 5 years. Okay student, okay. So now let us go for our condition. According to condition, the sum of the reciprocal of Rahman's age, sum means plus, and they are telling Rahman's reciprocal age. So what are the age of Rahman? X minus 3 and X plus 5. So if I do reciprocal, it will become 1/x-3. Sum means plus, and another age is 1/x+5. Our reciprocal age becomes 1/3. So now let us solve the problem. LCM will be X minus 3 into X plus 5. So 1 into X plus 5 will be X plus 5, plus 1 into X minus 3 will be same, X minus 3 is equal to 1/3. X plus X, 2X, 5 minus 3 will be 2, divided by X minus 3 into X plus 5. Is equal to 1/3. Okay students, multiply with 3, it will become 6x plus 6 is equal to this into this, so it will become x square minus 3x plus 5x minus 15. So 1 ke sath isko multiply karne se same ho jayega, sabko left side pe lao. So 6x plus 6 माइनस एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस 3x माइनस 5x प्लस 15 इज इक्वल टू 0. नाउ लेट अस एड अप. सो माइनस एक्स स्क्वायर, 6x प्लस 3x इज 9x, 9x माइनस 5x इज प्लस 4x, 6 प्लस 15 विल बिकम 21. Okay, student. Now let us go for factorization or middle term or by quadratic formula. So by quadratic formula, x is equal to minus b plus minus root over b square. B square means 4 square minus 4 into a value is minus 1 into c value is 21 divided by 2 into a. So this will be minus 4 plus minus 16 plus 21 fours are 84 divided by minus 2. So minus 4 plus minus root over 100 divided by minus 2. So minus 4 plus minus square root of 100 is 10 by minus 2. Break this. So minus 4 plus 10 by minus 2. Minus 4 minus 10 by minus 2. So 10 minus 4 is 6 by minus 2. Minus 14 by minus 2. Minus minus cancel. 2 7s are 2 3s are. So minus 3 comma 7. Therefore, present age of Rahman is 7 years. Minus 3 is not possible because our age cannot be negative. Negative age nahi hota hai. Isliye the present age of Rahman will be 7 years. Okay, student? Question number 5. In a class test, the sum of Saifali's mark in mathematics and English is 30. So let us consider the marks in the two subjects B, X and Y. Let the marks in mathematics and English be X and Y. So what is the first line? The sum of Saifali's marks in mathematics and English is 30. So as per question, sum of their marks means x plus y is equal to 30. And another statement is, had she got 2 marks more in mathematics, 2 marks more in mathematics means mathematics marks is x, so more means x plus 2, and 3 marks less in English. So less means minus 3. Their product is 210. Okay, student? So from here let us take out the value of y. So y is equal to 30 minus x. Equation 1. Substitute the value of y in equation 1. 30 minus x minus 3 is equal to 210. Using value of equation 1. So this will become x plus 2. 30 minus 3 is 27. Okay, student? Multiply 27x plus 54 minus x square minus 2x is equal to 210. So minus x square minus 2x plus 27x, it will become 25x equal to 210 minus 54. So minus x square plus 25x equal to 6, 5 minus 5, 156. So minus x square plus 25x minus 156 is equal to 0. Now let us go with the middle term. So our middle term of 25 is 12 and 13. So minus x square plus 12x plus 13x minus 156 is equal to 0. Okay, student? So let us take common. X is common, minus x plus 12. From here, if I take 13 common, so it will become, let us take minus common, so minus x plus 12 is equal to 0. So what are the two factors? Our two factors are x minus 13 and minus x plus 12 equal to 0. So either x minus 13 is equal to 0, x is equal to 13, or minus x is equal to minus 12, x is equal to 12. So we can see x is for the value of mathematics. So when our mathematics value is 13, from equation 1, when our x value is 13, our English value will become 30 minus x, means 30 minus 13 is equal to 17. Correct? And when our x value is 12, from equation 1, our y value will become 30 minus 12 is equal to 18. So the value marks are 13 and 17, and another value is 12 and 18. Correct, student? Now let us go to the next question. Question number 6. The diagonals of a rectangular field. So they are talking about rectangular field. So rectangular field means, let us consider one rectangular field. So we know rectangle means it has length and another part is breadth. So rectangular field contains length and breadth. So let us consider the value of length as x. Before that, let us read the question. The diagonal of a rectangular field is 60 meter more than the shorter side. So they are comparing about shorter side. So let us consider the shorter side be x. Let the shorter side be x meter. So let us consider this as shorter side, so it will become x. And diagonal becomes 60 more than shorter side. So our diagonal is x plus 60 meter. So our length will become, our length is 30 meter more than the shorter side. So shorter side is x, so 30 meter more means x plus 30. So it will become x plus 30 meter. Okay, student. So now see, we know in a rectangle, our this angle will be 90 degree. So we can apply here Pythagoras theorem. So by Pythagoras theorem, by Pythagoras theorem, this is our hypotenuse, this is perpendicular, this is base. So hypotenuse square is equal to base square plus perpendicular square. So let us break this x square plus 6 to the 12, 120x. 6 square 36 equal to x square plus 60x plus 900. Okay, student? Now let us take it to the left hand side. So x square plus 120x plus 3600 minus x square, it will become 2x square. Minus 60x minus 900 equal to 0. So x square minus 2x square will become minus x square. 120 minus 60 will become 60x. And this minus this will become 2700. So if you want, you can go for the middle term factorization, or you can go for the another method, that is quadratic formula. So if we go for middle term, our value will be minus x square plus 90x minus 30x plus 2700 is equal to 0. Take minus x common, so it will become x minus 90. Take minus 30 common, it will become x minus 90 is equal to 0. So minus x minus 30 is one factor, and another factor is x minus 90 equal to 0. Okay, student? So from here we can say either x minus 90 equal to 0, x is equal to 90, or minus x minus 30 is equal to 0, minus x is equal to 30, x is equal to minus 30. So this is not possible. Why it is not possible? Because this is measurement. So measurement cannot be negative. So here we can say our shorter side is 90 meter, longest side is x plus 30, that is 90 plus 30 is equal to 120 meter, and our diagonal is 90 plus 60 is equal to 150 meter. Got it, student? So the problem is very simple. Okay, so since this is a rectangular figure, so always remember that they may not give you the condition, but we know that one of the angle in a rectangle is 90 degree, so we can apply here Pythagoras theorem to solve the given problem. Okay, now let us go for the question number 7. What is question number 7? The difference of squares of two numbers is 180. The square of the smaller number is 8 times the larger number. Find the two numbers. They are talking about two numbers. So let us consider the two numbers be Let the two numbers be x and y. The difference of squares of two number. So what will be the square of the two number? Therefore, square of two numbers are x square and y square. So we can write as per question, the difference of squares of two number. So let us consider here, our x value is greater than y value, because during subtraction, what happens? When we go for subtraction, then only it is possible. One number should be bigger and the another number should be smaller. So we have to know which value is larger and which value is smaller. So let us consider that our x value is larger and our y value is smaller. So the difference of their number, x square minus y square, will become equal to 180 degree. Okay, student? So let me keep it as equation 1. And the another condition is, square of the smaller number is 8 times the larger number. So which is our smaller number? Y. So square of the smaller number is 8 times the larger number. So our larger number is x. So 8x. Keep it as equation 2. Now put the value of x square, y square in equation 1. Putting the value of y square in equation 1. So it will become x square minus 8x equal to 180. So x square minus 8x minus 180 is equal to 0. So if I go for factorization, 90, 45. Okay, student. Now we have to bring the value of 8. So how we will get the value of 8? Let us adjust here. 5 threes are 15. 4 threes are 12. So it is not possible. So 3 threes are 9, 9 twos are 18, and 5 twos are 10. So 18 minus 10 will become 8. So x square minus 18x plus 10x minus 180 is equal to 0. Let us take common x, x minus 18, 10, x minus 18 is equal to 0. So our two factors are x minus 18 and another factor is x plus 10 equal to 0. So from here we can see either x minus 18 is equal to 0, x is equal to 18, or x plus 10 is equal to 0, x is equal to minus 10. Okay, student? So from here we can say, what is our number? What they are asking in the question, find the two numbers. So our x value is 18. So when x is equal to 18, our y value from equation 2, y is equal to under root 8x. So under root of 8 into 18, 144, that is square root is 12 meter. Okay, student, so two numbers are, when x is equal to 18, our y value becomes 12, and when x is equal to 10, it is not possible since the negative value cannot be satisfied. Okay, student. y value is 12, and so here it will become plus minus. So when our two values are 18 and 12, and another value is 18 and minus 12, therefore the numbers are 18 and 12 and 18 comma minus 12. So this is the solution of the given question. Now let us go for the question number 8. What is our question number 8? A train travels 360 km at a uniform speed. If the speed had been 5 km more per hour, it would have taken 1 hour less for the same journey. Find the speed of the train. So let us consider the speed of the train B x kilometer per hour. Let the speed of the train B x kilometer per hour. So let us go to the condition. They have given distance equal to 360 kilometer. So dear student, whenever you got the problem related with speed and distance, we should use the formula distance equal to speed into time. So from here we can say time is equal to distance by speed, which is equal to 360 by x. So this is the time of the time taken by the train at the initial condition. Okay. What is our second condition? If the speed had been 5 km per hour more, so new speed of the train is, new speed of train is, they are telling 5 km per hour more. So initially it was x, now it will become x plus 5 km per hour. So from here our time will become distance by speed. Distance is 360, time is x plus 5. Correct, student? Now go for the question. According to question, write the initial value in the left hand side and the final value at the right hand side. They are telling the time taken is 1 hour less. Okay, student? So whenever they will tell less or more, just subtract or add with the initial condition. Okay, student? This should be subtracted or added with the initial condition. What is our initial condition? This. Don't go with the final condition. Okay? Now let us take the LCM. LCM is x. 360 minus x is equal to 360 by x plus 5. Cross multiply. 360 into x is 360x, plus x into this is minus x square, 5 into this plus 0, 6, 5, 30, 18 minus 5x is equal to 360x. So this gets cancelled. What is left? Minus x square minus 5x plus 1800 is equal to 0. So this is our condition. Now let us go with the middle term factorization. So our middle term value will be 8 minus x common, it will become x plus 45, plus 40 if I take common, x plus 45 is equal to 0. So our two conditions are minus x plus 40, and another condition is x plus 45 equal to 0. So either minus x plus 40 will be equal to 0. It implies minus x is equal to minus 40. So minus minus gets cancelled. X is equal to 40 kilometer per hour. So initial speed of the train will be 40 kilometer per hour, or x plus 45 is equal to 0. So x is equal to minus 45. So this is not possible. Why it is not possible? Because the speed of the train cannot be negative, means the train cannot go in the negative direction. Okay. Question number 9. Two water taps together can fill a tank in 9 3/8 hours. There are two taps. This is smaller tap, this is bigger tap. They are filling a tank in 9 3/8 hours. This is completely filled with water, and it takes 9 3/8 hours to fill the tank. The tap of the larger diameter takes 10 hours less than the smaller one. This is taking more time. Generally, this is smaller tap. So smaller tap will give less water as compared to the larger diameter tap. So let us consider this as x. So it will become x minus 10. Okay, student. So let the diameter of this smaller tap be x kilometer x, and larger tap be x minus 10 meter. According to question, find the time taken to separately fill the tank. So student, if I compare the smaller tap, so time taken by the smaller tap individually will be 1 by x, and the time taken by the larger diameter will be 1 by x minus 10. So it takes how much hour? It takes 1 by 9 3 by 8 hours. So this will become 1 by x plus 1 by x minus 10 is equal to 1 by 75 by 8. Take LCM here, x into x minus 10. So x minus 10 plus x is equal to 8 by 75. So twice x minus 10 by x square minus 10x is equal to 8 by 75. Cross multiply. 8 into x square is 8x square. 8 into 10 is minus 80x. 150x minus 750. Take it in the left hand side. So 8x square minus 230x plus 750 is equal to 0. Let us take 2 common. So it will become 4x square minus 115x plus 375 equal to 0. So 2 gets cancelled, 4x square minus 115x plus 375 is equal to 0. Now let us go with the middle term factorization, or you can go with the quadratic formula. So if I go with the quadratic formula, our value will become, or if you don't want, let us keep it like this only. Okay, so by quadratic formula, x equal to minus b plus minus root over b square minus 4 into a value is 8 into c minus 750 divided by twice a. So it will become 230 plus minus, what is 230 whole square? 230 whole square is 52900 minus 4 into 8 into 750 is equal to 2400 divided by 16. So 230 plus minus 28900 divided by 16. So 289 is the square root of 17 plus minus root 170 by 16. So take 1 time plus value, 1 time minus value. So 7400 by 16. This will become 60 by 16. Okay, student? Four 15s are 4 4s are. So our answer is 25, 15/4. So this is not possible because our total time is 9.3/8 hours. So the time taken by the smaller tap is 25 hours and the larger tap is 25 minus 10 is 15 hours. Therefore, time taken by smaller tap equal to 25 hours and time taken by larger tap equal to 25 minus 10 is equal to 15 hours. Okay, student.